Turns out there is. Enough talking, let's actually dive in and see what these two pieces of clothing are like. Hey team, welcome to today's video and welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. My name is Hayden. It has been a bit of a minute since I have reviewed a clothing, men's fashion, fast fashion kind of a thing. Now we've done Shein, we've done Wish. To keep it in vain, I wanted to see if there was another app out there or another organization, another website, if you will, that did fast fashion for men. Turns out there is, and it's called Light in the Box. I am unaware if it is available outside of Australia, so this may be irrelevant. However, if you want to look it up, I have it on my iPhone. I jumped on there and I decided I was going to find, or try to find, something that was affordable and seemed nice. Kind of like what you find on Shein. Now, this is not as cheap as Shein, as in the money that you pay. Now, if you hear clip-clopping, it's because the dog, Myrtle, won't stay still, and her nails are annoying everyone. What do you want? You're not getting the plastic. I'm sure if you've been following me for a while, you can see that I'm back in my home, and yes, it looks a lot fresher, because it's been renovated. That is a video that will be coming along with my entire scathing review of my former insurance company, RACV. Useless. Anyway, I digress. Back to the topic at hand, Light in the Box. Now, like I was just saying before, it's not as affordable as what Shein is. I'm hoping though, it doesn't however break the bank. Now I picked up two articles of clothing from Light in the Box. I picked up a shirt, a men's polo shirt, golf shirt, polo collar, short sleeve. Wow. And that was $15.69 Australian. The other item I picked up was the men's jeans, tapered pants, trousers, distressed jeans. Whoever comes up with these names, I mean really. And that was $35.49. So as you can see, it is higher up the scale than what you would find at Shein. But let's hope that the quality is better. Once I placed this order, it did take around 2 weeks to arrive. That being said, I did pay for additional fast shipping, which was $13, and then shipping insurance, which was $1.54. The entire amount I paid was $65.72. Enough talking, let's actually dive in and see what these two pieces of clothing are like. Here's what it looks like. For two pieces of clothing, I am a little concerned. That's very small. Shein, however, is the same. So as we open them up, we've got the two pouches, the jeans, and the shirt. Now, without actually touching the fabric to see what it's like, it doesn't look too bad. I mean, there are a few, you can see the stitching in there isn't fantastic, but you tend to get that with cheaper clothing. The jeans look all right, but I haven't actually touched them yet. Let's open up the shirt. So that's very similar packaging to Shein, where it's got that Ziploc pouch. The crunch test. Feels like fabric. It doesn't give that, you know, crunchy plastic kind of a vibe. So taking the shirt out, here's what it looks like. Doesn't smell funky, that's a bonus. It feels good. It actually feels like it's a better quality to what you would find on Shein and Wish. Well, everything's better than Wish. The real test is to put it on to see if it fits, to see if it's flattering. I do feel like it's a little long. This is a medium, so both of them came in a medium, or that I ordered in a medium. I feel like this is boxy and a little too long. Let's try it on and have a look. You know, I don't think it's too bad actually. I think it came out quite nice. It feels nice on, it doesn't feel like it's a fabric that's going to irritate you. And as you can see, it is flattering in the places you want it to be flattering. I like the print and the cut of it. I thought it was going to be too boxy, and too long, but it's actually pretty good. So far, so good.
Okay, so 1 out of 2, not bad. The real test is going to be the jeans. In my experience, there has not been many, or if maybe one, if at all, but there has not been many occasions when a cheaper end of the scale pair of jeans has one fitted well, two lived up to what it was advertised, and three didn't stink. Smell test, it's not too bad. It smells like petroleum jelly. Why that first came to my mind, I don't know. It feels like jeans. It doesn't have that kind of stretchy jean-like material vibe. It feels coarse and there's no stretch. Taking them out. I love how they're called fashion jeans, Vogue style. So first impressions, they look all right. They feel okay. You can see the inside. It actually looks like jean material. It feels like it. It's thinner. It's not a thick denim, what you would normally find on Wranglers or anything like that. And it doesn't actually, like denim, it doesn't have a lot of give, but you can see there is some stretch to them. So 100% it's not pure denim. It is 88% cotton and 12% polyester. Okay, so that's not too bad. Now these again are a medium. Real tested to put them on to see if they're flattering, see if they're going to strangulate me, or if I can even get them up over my hips. Okay, we've ran into a problem. Now they do fit. They're a little too big and too long, but the part where you're supposed to put the button in is sewed shut. I may need to just cut that myself and see if I can make it work. I'll be right back. Okay, so I had to do a little bit of adjusting. Now you can see they are very long. So from the button, which is just under my belly button, to the crutch, they've got all of this space. But if you look past that, you can see when the shirt is down, they actually don't look too bad. They've got a lot of give in them. They don't smell terrible. And the material doesn't feel like it's going to irritate. However, I did have to cut the hole to put the button in. So whether or not that's going to stay neat or it's going to fray apart, we'll have to wait and see. And we haven't actually done a machine wash. Of the two pieces of clothing, the t-shirt is far better quality, in my opinion, but we'll just have to wait and see how they hold up. Okay, now that we've got both of them on, you know, the funny thing is, I actually think that my Shein haul, the original one, well, if you remove the pants from that equation because they weren't good, but that original haul had a better outcome. Only one of the pieces from the two that I've ordered do I think that is worth the money, considering I had to cut the buttonhole into the pants and they're rather ill-fitting. Like I just said before in the previous clip, I don't think it's material that's going to be irritating. And there's, I do like pants that have a lot of give, and that's because when you go to sit down, you move and all of that, it moves with you rather than resists you and keeps you confined. For the money that I've paid for these, $35 something, I shouldn't have to alter them in order to put them on. You would assume that pants will come with a buttonhole. If you want to check out Light in the Box yourself, now this is my first time shopping for clothing with them. Whether or not I'll get more pieces just to see if there is a trend or consistency, I may have to do that. Let me know your thoughts, let me know your opinions. Thanks for watching, team.